Quantas are minimization. So let us go in depth about this topic. As we saw in the earlier topic, Boolean algebra, it is a one method to simplify the Boolean expression. Okay, so the other method to simplify the Boolean expression is a K-map. Okay, so the main purpose of the K-map is to reduce the or minimize the Boolean expression. Okay, so why we need to reduce this Boolean expression? What causes, what will be the impact we didn't do reduction of this Boolean expression? But the thing why we are going this simplification is, when you not simplify the Boolean expression, it increases the hardware cost. There will be more number of variables and lot of gates you need to use for designing a circuit, and that becomes complex. So the design of a circuit becomes complex and the hardware cost is high, and these kind of difficulties we face when we are not reducing the Boolean expression. So that is why we going for a Boolean algebra and K-map for simplifying the expression. And why we are coming to K-map? Why not this Boolean expression? So the first thing is difficult to apply in systematic way, difficult to tell when you have arrived at a minimum solution. So K-map can be used to minimize function of up to 6 variables. In Boolean algebra, the difficulty in the Boolean reduction is, if the number of variable increases, you cannot able to reduce the Boolean expression. But in the K-map, it is a systematic way, and it is very simple to reduce the Boolean expression. It can reduce the expression when there are more number of variables is also there, it can able to reduce the Boolean expression. Okay, so K-map can be used to minimize functions of up to 6 variables. K-map is directly applied to two level networks composed of AND and OR gate, that is sum of product and product of sum. Okay, so it has a minimum number of term, that is, it has a minimum number of gates, it has a minimum number of gate inputs. So when you try to reduce a Boolean expression, the number of gates will get reduced, and the number of input variables also get reduced. So that is minimum number of literals. Each term in the minimum is sum of product is a prime implicant, that is, it cannot be combined with others. So it may not be unique. It depends upon the order in which the terms are combined and eliminated. So these are all some advantages of using the K-map. Okay, as you can see, the vertical input scheme. Okay, so here you can see that there are three input AND gates and one OR gate. And here also there are three input AND gates. So it just represents how this logic circuit designs for a minimum SOP, that form a function using vertical input scheme. So here without fan-in reduction, here with fan-in reduction. So the first figure shows with fan-in reduction, here with fan-in reduction. Okay, so it has a minimum number of factors, it has minimum number of literals, and it may not be unique. Use x plus y into x plus y bar, which is equals to x. So use x plus c into x bar plus d into c plus d, which is equivalent to x plus c into x bar plus d to eliminate the terms. So we'll come back to this picture later. Okay, so now let us see the types of K-map. So K-map is a pictorial representation, okay, for reducing the Boolean expression. So we used to place ones and zeros from the truth table in the K-map, and K-map comes with a lot of squares. Each square of ones is equals to minterm. Minterm in adjacent squares can be combined since they differ in one to one variable. Say for example, x y bar plus x y is equals to x. See, in this picture, in this slide, I have given two variable K-map. But for two variable in the sense there are 2 power to 4 combinations, so 0 0 0 1 1 0 1 1. So the way you have to construct k-map is a k-map with 4 cells, a square box with 4 cells, and here the first combination you should write here in the first cell, that is 0 1 2 3. So this is the order you need to fill the value. So for 0 0 input combination, what is the output value? 1. For 0 1, so for 0 1 you have to see row and column. So for 0 1 the value you need to fill is 0, and for 1 and 0 you have to fill it as 1. 0 1 0 1 2 3. Okay, so now the next thing is you need to group the adjacent ones. So the adjacent one here is, here you can see the adjacent ones. So combine the adjacent ones, group the adjacent ones and write the expression as a bar b bar plus a bar b, and reducing that you will get a bar. So this is without without grouping k-map. Here after grouping the k-map. So note BC is listed in the order 0, 0, 0, 1, 1, 1, 1, 0. See, in the 3 variable k-map, you can see you have to write in this order. That is 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is how you need to write. The cell order should be different in the three variable k map. And after you place ones in the k map, after you place ones in the k map, you need to group it accordingly. So the grouping may starts with maximum number of ones. It may be 16 ones are 8 ones, that is octet, required, that is 4 ones and 2 ones. So this is how all the adjacent ones in this count can be grouped together. If there is no way of adjacent ones not in the k-map, then you have to group it alone. Okay, so it is you have to isolate those ones. And adjacent terms in 3 variable came up. Okay, so here you can see 0, 1, 2 is here and 3, 4, 5 and 6 here, and 7 should be right in here. So that here you can see a simple way of understanding where you have to place the output values in the cell. So the cell order in the 3 variable came up is 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So this is how you need to place the 3 variable came up. Either you can draw this table in horizontal way or vertical way. Let us see an example of k-map. So here they are asking you to construct k-map for the following function: if a comma b comma c is equals to summation m of 1 comma 3 comma 5, which is equivalent to that is, you can also do both sum of product and product of sum. So now for this given, I'm just doing k-map for sum of product. So what will the cell number given here? 1 3 5. So from that cell you have to put correct one here, 1 3 5. So the corresponding cell you need to place 1. The next point you need to do is grouping. So which is adjacent ones here? So here you can see 1 and 3 are adjacent and 1 and 5 are adjacent. A overlap is possible. You should not do more overlapping. If it is required, you can do overlapping. Okay, in the next picture, see, this will show you what are the possible way of grouping the 3 variable k-map. So these 4 ones, these 2 ones and this one are also adjacent to each other. So these kind of possibilities you can group it. Okay. So, and so here we are plotting for the given function. We are first this is not actually in the form of canonical. You need to make it as canonical form. So the first thing is you need to convert this general form into canonical form. There you will get a standard form of Boolean expression. After that, it is very easy to find out which cell you need to place one. Okay, so once you have done the standard canonical form, then you can place ones in the cell, and finally you can group it. Okay, so simplification example. So here you can see f of a comma b comma c is equals to summation m of 1 comma 3 comma 5. So the first procedure for this is place a min term into a map. So what are the min terms here? 1, 3 and 5. F is equals to summation m of 1 comma 3 comma 5. Okay, so grouping this you will get these two ones are adjacent and these two ones are adjacent to each other. So how we can write this? See here, the 0 1 true form, normal form get cancelled, and you have to take the common value 1 here. So what is 1 here? C. Okay, so you have to take this C and take down this term. This is A bar and this is A bar and this is A and A bar or A bar A. So if it is A bar, you have to see the row and column. So this row is, one minute. So this, the one placed in the row is B bar C. So B bar C A bar, and for this value A bar B C. Okay, so take this value and write this, and minimizing this you will get A bar C. Okay, so this is how you need to, after you plot the k-map for the given minterm, you need to simplify by grouping the adjacent ones. Always try to group octuk and then go for quad, and finally if it is not possible, go for isolated. Okay, and the complement of f, the complement of f is nothing but they will give min term. From the min term you need to complement it. So whatever number that doesn't appear, that number you have to take it for complement. Okay, so here is an example of the grouping ones in the three variable schema. So as you can see, these two ones and these two ones are adjacent to each other. You never do these two one adjacent and these two one separately, like two grouping of two ones. This is four grouping of four ones. Okay, and here you can group it. See, there is no way you can group with this one. You cannot isolate this because you have one here. Even though if it is overlapping, you can take it, you can consider it. Okay, if there is no one in this place, then no other go, you need to isolate this one. So redundant, if a term is covered by two other terms, that term is redundant. Okay, if a term is covered by two other terms, that term is redundant. That is, it is a consensus term. Example, why is a redundant one? See here, as I said in the previous slide, if it is required only, you need to do overlapping. Otherwise, you need not do overlapping. So this will lead to hazard. Okay, there will be unnecessary gate should be used for this, and there will be delay in producing the output. So this is what you call as redundant term. See here, this one you have grouped it, and this one you have grouped it. Again, you need not group this one and this one. Already it is in one is in this group, one is in group. So they have its own group. So you need not group it again. Okay, so these duplications need to be avoided, and that term is what we called as redundant term. Okay, more than two minimum solutions. Yes, sure, there will be a lot of possible ideas comes from different minds. Okay, it's not that what I have done is right. The other may also do a different way of grouping, so that should be acceptable. See, for this given problem, f is equal to summation m of 0 1 2 5 6 7, placing all the ones in after you plotted a k map, I can group this here, and these two ones are adjacent to each other, and these two ones are each other. The other way also you can group it, because these two are also adjacent to each other. So that one grouping and these two grouping and these two grouping. This is possible. So more than two minimum solutions can also be arrived for plotting a k-map or for given Boolean expression. The next one, four variable k-map. So each minterm is adjacent to four terms. So here everything is same. The thing what I feel different here is the cell number. So here we have to use 16 cell number, and along with we have to the grouping, the number of one grouping is get increased because it has 16 cells. So we have to group 16 ones. We have to try to group a maximum of 16 ones. Okay. So here each min term is adjacent to four terms which it can be combined. So 0, 8 are adjacent squares, and 0, 2 are adjacent squares, and 1, 4, 13, 7 are adjacent to 5. Okay, see, look at here. We have a cell number 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 should be at last, and then 12, 13, 14, 15. You can also write like this, or you can also write like this horizontal way. 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. Sorry, 8, 9, 11, 10 should be at last. So 8, 9, 10, 11. 12, 13, 14 and 15. So this is the order also you can consider for placing ones in the respective cell. Okay. So for the given expression, and again as I told you, this is not in the normal form, I mean standard canonical form. In order to place ones in the respective cell of a four variable k-map, one has to convert a standard canonical form, sum of product, standard canonical sum of product has to be converted. After that only you can able to place you can able to find in which cell you can place the ones for the given expression. So see, I have done all this conversion, and I found where I have to place the ones here, and this is where I have to place all the ones. As you can see, this grouping is somewhat different from the two variable and three variable, because the number of cells are increased here. See, these four ones are adjacent to each other, so it's a octet group. It's not four and four, it is octet group. It has to be opened because this four and four has to be combined together to form 8 ones. Okay, and here you can see 4 ones and 2 ones here. Again, you need not group these 2 ones, so there should not be a redundant term here. Okay, if you group it, there will be a redundant term will come, that leads to an hazard problem. Okay, let us see a few more examples in the four variable. So min terms are combined into groups of 2, 4, 8 to eliminate 1, 2, 3 variable. Okay, and corner terms. Okay, so here you can see these corner terms also you need to consider 1, 1, 1, 1. So all these ones are grouped to form a 4 ones. Okay. So grouping is very important in the k-map, because if you didn't do well, then the reduced expression won't be have an accuracy of arriving the Boolean expression. So now let us see simplification with don't care. So don't care can be represented in the k-map as the variable x. Okay, don't care x is covered if it helps, otherwise delivered. Only if it is necessary you can consider the don't care, otherwise you need not consider the don't care. Okay, see here, this x is helpful for grouping 4, so at that time I can take it. You need not group x alone. Okay, here also you no need to group this one with x if it is required only, because already this one is in a group. Okay, so you need not take the 6. Okay, see the problem. Look at here, summation m of 1, 3, 5, 7, 9. So in those places we have put ones here. How we can put x here? In the given question, summation d represents don't care. So in those cells you have to put x. So the don't care can be represented with the variable x. So here you have to place x here. Okay, and after grouping, the reduced expression is a bar d plus c bar d. Now get a minimum product of sum using k-map. So in in the sum of product we place one in the cell, but in product of sum we used to place zeros instead of ones. We used to place zeros in the cell, so we want zero in each term. Okay, see, this is a given expression. For this given expression, you need to first convert standard form, okay, and identify what are the mean terms for the given expression. Say for example, the mean term may be m0 m2 m5, and from this summation of m0 m1 m5, from this you need to find what are the missing terms in the function, given Boolean function. So those missing terms you have to take it, and those numbers will be considered as product of sum. Okay, and that in those numbers you need to place zeros. Okay, see, for this we found f is equals to y plus z bar into y bar plus x bar plus z into y plus x bar plus y bar. Okay, in those places you need to put zeros here. And other thing that different in POS and SOP represent. Here 0 0 we will consider as A bar B bar, but here we need to consider as A B, and we have to, the way you have to write the expression is A plus B, A plus A bar plus B, and A bar plus B bar, and A bar plus B. So this is how you need to write. Here also, see, here in this expression we use wx variable. So w plus x, w plus x bar, w bar plus x bar, w bar plus x. So this is how everything should be represented in the form of POS. Okay. So determination of minterm expression using essential prime implicants. So let us see what are the prime essential implications for determining minimum expressions. So, implicant, prime implicant, essential, prime implicant. Implicants, an implicant of a function f is a single element of the odd set or any group of elements that can be combined together in a key map. So prime implicants, any implicant that cannot be combined with another to eliminate a literal. So essential prime implicants, if a particular element of the onset is covered by single prime implicant, so that implement is called as essential prime implicant. See, I'll repeat, implicant of a function f is a single element of the onset or any group of elements. It may be a single or any group of elements that can be combined together in a k-map. Prime implicants, an implicant that cannot be combined. First one is you can combine, but prime implicant you cannot combine with another to eliminate the literal. Essential prime implicants, if a prime implicant, if the particular element of the onset is covered by a single prime implicant, that implicant is called as essential prime implicant. So all essential primes must be a part of a minimized expression. So implicant of f, so any single one or any group of one, as I said earlier. Prime implicant, it cannot be combined with another term to eliminate a variable. Say for example, a bar b bar c comma a bar c b bar comma a c bar are prime implicants. Here a bar b bar c bar d bar is not combined with a bar b bar c d bar. Because A, B, C bar and A, B bar, C bar are not. Okay, so they are not combined with these. Okay, see, here you can see in a pictorial game of representation, you may have this group. And here you may have the four ones are grouped already, but inside you can group these two ones separately. So they are not. See, these are all prime implicant. Already it is prime implicant. You cannot combine you cannot combine with another term to eliminate a variable. Okay. So any single one which is not adjacent to any other ones, two adjacent ones which are not contained in a group of four ones, and so on. So shaded loops are also prime implicants but not a part of minimum solution. A bar, C bar, D, and B bar, C bar, D already covered by other groups, so we do need we do not need them. Okay. Essential prime implicants for minimum SOP. See, in the previous example, if CD is chosen first, then EF has four terms. So we don't need a CD since it is covered by other group. So already it is covered by other group. CD is not at all a essential prime implicant too. Here M2 is essential, this M2, minimization 2. M2 is essential prime implicant since it is covered only B1 prime implicant. So does M5, M14, we need them in the answer, right? Rule of thumb. So look all the squares adjacent to a minterm. If the given minterm and all of the ones adjacent to it are covered by a single term, then the term is an essential prime implicant. But it is covered by more than two prime implicant, we can not tell whether this term is essential or not. So the solution is A bar C bar plus A bar B bar D CD plus A bar B B R B C D. So say here the blue one, the shaded blue, are covered by only one prime implicant. All other ones are covered by at least two prime implicant. Okay, so we have discussed here is about K map. The K map is one which is useful using the Boolean expression. So compared to Boolean algebra, this is very simple and systematic way of arriving a minimal solution. So whereas if the number of variables are increased in the Boolean function by means of Boolean algebra, it's very difficult to arrive a minimal solution. But K-map, it is a systematic way of reducing the Boolean expression. So which we can have a two level of network composed of AND and OR gate, sum of product and product of sum. And there are different types. You can plot K map according to the number of variables. There are two variable K map, three variable, four variable, five variable, and six variable K maps are there. When you go beyond this six, it is very, even K map is very difficult to reduce the minimal solution, because if there are five and six variables of a K map, if you plot it, it is very difficult to group ones in the one, because we will use more number of cells. Okay, so it is very difficult to group or combine a number of tables together. So that is a big challenge of K map. Here, when the number of variable increases, it is very difficult to reduce the Boolean expression. Okay, so other than that, it is very simple, and anyone can do this Boolean expression. The procedure for reducing Boolean expression using K-map is you have to check how many number of variables given in the Boolean function. So according to that, you have to plot a K-map. The K-map comes with number of cells. If it is two variable, four cells; three variable, eight cells; and four variable, 16 cells; five variable, 32 cells; six variable, 64 cells. Okay, and we have a cell number. There is a different way of arranging the cell numbers inside the square box. So according to that, we need to place ones or zeros. If it is product of sum, we need to place ones. If it is sum of product, we need to place one. If it is product of sum, we need to place zero. And other than that, the procedure is same. You need to group the ones or zeros. And the way you group is very important. Always you have to choose maximum grouping of ones, like it starts with 16, 8 and then 4, 2. If no other way, you can go for isolate the one, okay, and then you can reduce the expression further, okay. So next session we will discuss a few more examples.